In the mid-1970s, the discredited federal government was more scared of the public than ever, coming off the years of Richard Nixon. And so two cold warriors inside the White House of Gerald Ford begin to bring back some of the Cold War ideas of an executive takeover of the United States through an emergency federal agency. And those individuals were Donald Rumsfeld and Dick Cheney. And so really what we see being set up by Jimmy Carter in 1979 is just a continuation of federal policy to expand a federal takeover plan for continuity of government. And so that's what the Federal Emergency Management Agency was really set up for.
Colonel North, in your work at the NSC, were you not assigned at one time to work on plans for the continuity of government in the event of a major disaster?
Mr. Chairman,
I believe that question touches upon a highly sensitive and classified area, so may I request that you not touch upon that, sir.
One of the programs that got exposed during Iran Contra was Rex 84. And Congressman Jack Brooks, in those hearings, brought up the fact that in reality, FEMA was a cover for a huge continuity of government program in case the American people ever rebelled. And that was the architecture of the blueprint for the illegitimate shadow government to fully take over the functions of the entire federal government, suspend the Constitution, suspend the Bill of Rights, and arrest whoever they wanted to. And FEMA was going to control the camps that the people were going to be put into. And FEMA would be the main governmental institution with different directors over every agency. And now when you watch FEMA on television, it's always a colonel or a general or an admiral in uniform who's over the different departments.
The martial law portions of Rex 84 were outlined in a 1982 memo written by FEMA Deputy John Brinkerhoff. Martial law was to be declared in the event of a national crisis, yet the plan did not define the term national crisis. The plan allowed FEMA to take control of both federal and state governments, appointing military commanders to replace duly elected officials. The plan also called for the rounding up of at least 21 million American Negroes for delivery to numerous military bases converted into prison centers, also known as FEMA relocation camps. Why? Because at that time, African Americans were classified as one of the largest threats to the continuity of the federal government. Who does the federal government consider the biggest threat these days?
The convergence of globalization and technology has created a new brand of terrorism. There were persons who, for whatever reason, came to view their home country as the enemy.
The kind of right-wing, religious-based domestic terrorism.
Disturbing news tonight about homegrown terror.
Part of this is big change in the White House, a new cultural experience, and some of the crazies are coming out of their closet.
Right now, it looks like there is no connection between the men arrested and any known terrorist cell.
Homegrown.
Homegrown, I should say.
Folks, we've got a very serious situation here. I'm holding what is called the right-wing extremism, current economic and political climate, fueling resurgence and radicalization and recruitment. And in it, we talked about the fact that they define pro-lifers as domestic terrorists. They put this in a Department of Homeland Security document, this official assessment, now saying pro-lifers, people that believe in end-time prophecies, people that are opposed to the administration's position on immigration, those of us that are standing up for the sanctity of life and for the sanctity of marriage, all of those are now potential, and this is what they're saying, domestic terrorists.
It's a terrorist next door that could be our bigger threat.
They call people who believe in the sanctity of life, who believe in owning firearms, who believe in serving their country in the military and coming back, who are very concerned about the policies that this nation is embarking on, spending too much money, taxing too much. It's all listed right here. These are the domestic right-wing extremists.
1 million names under the watchful eye of the United States. America's so-called terrorist watch list has hit the record number, according to one of the country's most prominent civil liberties groups.
That's a lot of people to keep track of. They're adding new people all the time.
It's a secret list that you don't know really quite how one gets on, and you don't know how you get off.